Hopeless Romantic. That's the name of my newest project, and I know I'm a little biased, but I think that you should definitely go listen to it, go stream it, go share it with your friends. But hey, maybe that's just my opinion. But yeah, last week I discussed who Lucia is, and that Lucia being the main character told throughout the story that is a character in every single song on the project. And in this video, I'm gonna very quickly kind of just sum up who she is, but if you want a lot more detail on who she is, then I would go watch that video so you can have a bit of a better understanding for this video and for the project as a whole. But yeah, to put it simply, she is a representation of the quote-unquote perfect girl. On top of that, she isn't just one singular person, she takes on the persona of several different people, of three specifically. So, what is the Hopeless Romantic story? What is the literal story that's told in the songs, and what is the actual, I guess literal and actual stories are kind of the same thing, but what is the actual real-life story that helped inspire these songs? I'm going to be discussing both of those in this video because there's definitely a lot of inaccuracies and just summing a lot of stuff up in these songs that obviously, you know, that doesn't happen in real life. There's also a lot of metaphors and imagery used throughout the project that kind of intentionally misleads the reader because the project is portrayed from the main character's eyes. It's not, you know, this third party that's viewing the scenario. It's all from the main character's eyes, the main character who is intentionally very flawed. So the very first song is called Everything Stalker. So the literal translation of the song, well, the actual lyrics don't specifically mention that the main character is stalking this other person, this girl being Lucia, but we're told that he is through the name of the song, and this kind of makes sure that the listener, or hopefully makes sure that the listener, doesn't take everything that the main character says to heart. It's definitely not meant to be, he's not meant to be the greatest icon in the world. The listener to the song, through the name of the song, should realize that he or she should not be idolizing another person in the same creepy way that the main character in the song is doing. That being said, the main character is idolizing this girl through a variety of ways in the song, through his voice and the cheerful beat. As far as the lyrics go, the main character is pretty much just listing off all of the stuff that he would do for this person. He'd spend all of his money, he'd rob for her, he'd die for her, he'd be his guardian angel for her, sort of. He says that he'd pretty much be a guardian angel for her against all strangers in the world, making sure that anyone that he doesn't know or that they don't know, that they don't approach her ever. So he's a guardian angel against outside threats, but not more personal threats. Because he idolizes this person so much, he trusts everything that this person does and is willing to do absolutely anything for this person. So if she were to ever be in a scenario where she would want to commit suicide, something along those lines, then he, in his idolization of Romeo and Juliet, he would allow her to commit suicide, and then he would also commit suicide with her. That is how terrifying his idolization is. And he says all of this crazy stuff in his own version of quote-unquote love. This is how he interprets love. And then, playing on the Romeo and Juliet theme, he, at the end of the song, he asks over and over and over again, would you die for me? Would you die for me? And then at the end of all of these questions asking would she die for him, he realizes that she's not going to want to die for him, but nonetheless, he's going to die for her. And, you know, looking at it from an outside perspective, it's pretty obvious that, you know, she's not going to die for him because they don't actually talk. He just kind of follows her around. He plays this guardian angel role where he's just looking over her, but never actually interacting with her. And now a quick disclaimer before I get into any of the real life interpretations of any of these songs. I'm obviously not going to put any names or any dates to anything. This project is essentially meant to be like a psychoanalysis of the main character, or of me, at different points in my life, or of different points of my love life. Nothing that I say in any of the songs is meant to be a critique or an attack on anyone. And if there is anything that I say that is negative towards someone else in any of these songs, then it's probably either an exaggeration of something, or it's something that's completely inaccurate to what actually happened in real life, or is some sort of unsubstantiated thought that the main character is having, or rather an unsubstantiated thought that I might have had at one point in my life. Or it could also be a simplification of a much more complex scenario. And all of these things were done in order to keep the project really concise and just kind of stick to the themes of the project and not, you know, go out of my way or not to overstep. All of the real life people that these songs are about are awesome people, and I wish them all nothing but the best. With all that being said, the real story, the actual story behind Everything Stalker, is that there was someone who I didn't really know. I'd only actually talked to them like a small handful of times. But regardless of that, I completely idolized them. I made them out to be this perfect person in my mind and convinced myself that they were, or that I was destined to be together with this person. I told myself that I would do anything for them, I would die for them. The song was definitely influenced a pretty big amount by Grenade, by Bruno Mars, or kind of, I guess my life in general at that point was kind of really influenced by that song. And no, I did not actually stalk them, I just... This sounds really creepy. There's no good way of explaining this that doesn't come off creepy, but I guess I just watched them whenever they were around or looked at them whenever they were around. Yeah, it was just a really strong crush. I know there's no good way of saying that doesn't come off creepy, but yeah, it was just a really strong crush. But yeah, I never went out of my way in order to follow them or did anything creepy in that regard. So yeah, that's the story behind the very first song, Everything Stalker. Next up is the third song, the halfway marker of the project, the single for the project, and that is Without You. And the literal translation for this song is that, once again, I've gone back to idolizing this original person, Lucia, and I keep on getting frustrated that we're not just magically becoming, that relationship isn't just magically starting. The main character says that he doesn't want to do anything without her. He doesn't even want to leave his house unless if he knows that he's going to be going out in order to see her. And then all of a sudden, his dreams come true, and this girl teleports right in front of him. She says that, as he imagined, she's known the entire time exactly how he's felt, and that she's just been playing the long game, making sure that he was truly the one, that he had the patience. She pretty much says that she was just testing his loyalty, and that it was okay for him to have, you know, fallen once for someone else, or kind of gone astray one time, but that she understands where his mind was coming from. Yeah, and then they start dating, and all of this dating fulfills all of his dreams, all of his expectations. It frees him of his boredom, at least for when he's around the other person, but when he's without her, he is pretty much in the same boat as he was before. He's still miserable. He doesn't want to go anywhere in the world unless if he's going out in order to see this person. So while he's gotten everything that he's ever wanted, he's also pretty much in the same boat that he was before, or at least when he's not physically around this person, he's pretty much in the same boat that he was before. Now, the real life story of this, the feelings for that very first person, those completely went away, and then, you know, caught feelings for another person. We started dating eventually, pretty quickly actually, I would say, and, you know, all of those expectations I had originally had placed on that first person were met with the second, or not the second person, but with this person, and so I instead idolized this person, and yet, despite me having a fantastic time when I was at least with this person, when I wasn't around this person, I was completely miserable like I was before. I didn't really want to hang out with other people. I still did, but it definitely wasn't my first choice. Now, the fourth song, Light/Grin, this is the breakup song on the project, but it's the breakup song of someone who gets completely blindsided by it. It's kind of the moments leading up to it in a certain light. And this explains why pretty much the entire song, except for the outro, sounds like really cheerful and uplifting, at least through the beat and the lyrical performance, my voice in the song. The main character is still super happily in love as he goes to this new place. Lucia leads him up to this new room where he's supposed to live for now, and she's about to leave, but the main character kind of tries to follow her out, and she's gotta tell him, like, no, you actually need to stay here, like, I can't be with you right now. And this disappoints him, but he's so in love with her that he's like, okay, like, I get it, I'll stay here. It's not going to feel very good. I'm not going to have a very good time here by myself, but that's fine. You go out, you go do your thing. You know, she promises that they'll meet up again soon. This obviously doesn't end up happening, and in his loneliness, in him being completely by himself, stranded, he you know, he starts writing love songs, doing this, doing that. He tells her that he loves her and then doesn't get a reply back, and then they break up. And then in the outro of the song is when he really starts to sound really sad and depressed, and he's really just trip begging her to come back. He panics, he throws a tantrum, he tells her that he's a hopeless romantic, and then that leads into the last song. Now, the real life story is that me and this person, we both went to different places, and we tried for a little while to have a long-distance relationship work out, but it was obviously too hard for both of us. And I thought that things were going perfectly fine relationship-wise, even though I might have been miserable on my own. I thought that the relationship itself was fine. I did write a love song, though I'm not going to lie, that love song was completely garbage. That was, looking back, that if I were to record that nowadays, that would easily be one of my worst songs ever. But that's whatever. We then broke up, which completely blindsided me, same as in the song. And then I pretty much started begging and, I guess, throwing a tantrum and, you know, panicking, like I said in the song, that or hoping or begging her to come back. And then the last song, this is the first song, or I guess the only song, actually, where the literal translation of what's happening in the song and the real life story are could not be further apart in like 99% of it. In the song, the main character has been trapped in this room for a very long time and is committing suicide until he hears this knock at the door from someone, and then this person lets them out. He thanks this person over and over. He thanks her. And then slowly starts to realize or become skeptical of this person, and asks them to, quote-unquote, take off their mask. And after she does take off this mask, he realizes that it's Lucia. And so, given their history, this absolutely terrifies the main character, who, in what he perceives to be self-defense, he grabs a knife and he stabs her. And then in the hook, he says that he'll kill you, with a pretty strong emphasis on the word you. And in the last video, and also in my next video, I'm going to discuss a bit more about who you is. But to put it simply, it's either you can interpret it at you as being Lucia, or you can interpret you as being whoever the main character ends up having a crush on next. Now, the real life story, obviously I was not actually trapped in any room, but instead I sort of trapped myself in this room, or just kind of stayed in my room at this new place for as much as I possibly could. I pretty much avoided the world like I had done before, but now that I could never see this other person, I couldn't see them as a relationship, and I also couldn't see them even if just like going out in public, seeing them like I would in the very first song, Everything Stalker. And so without being able to go out and physically see this person, I, you know, drove myself insane, even worse than I had done before when I at least had that opportunity, which, along with a lot of other factors that were entirely my fault, led me to very briefly sort of commit suicide, consider suicide, but not very seriously. But yeah, I didn't really leave that room or go out and talk to new people until someone else that I barely knew, that I rarely talked to, would pretty much just kind of drag me out of that room. I, for a short amount of time, started to catch some feelings for this person. I started to think to myself that maybe they're the perfect person, or at least the perfect person for me. I thought that maybe they were the person that I've been looking for, the person that I've been idolizing for so long, but I ultimately cut off that relationship for a number of reasons. But the biggest reason was that I definitely hadn't moved on fully from that previous relationship. And it was also because, like I mentioned in my last video, it was also because I was actively looking for flaws in other people, looking for differences in me or in other people compared to me. I was intentionally trying to find reasons to diminish this other person in my own mind. And as I also mentioned in the last video, I ended up doing this with a lot of different people over the years and to this day, to be honest. So that is the story behind Hopeless Romantic, both the literal translation and the real life story behind it. If you haven't listened to the project yet and if you've watched this video all the way through and it sounds interesting to you, then please go listen to it. And after you do, let me know what you think about the project in the comments down below. And if you have listened to it, keep listening to it, share it with your family, share it with your friends, share it with whoever you think might like some songs from the project or the project as a whole, share it with everyone. And with that, thank you for watching, and as always, welcome to the crew.